Our objective is to learn about the technique and applications of DNA fingerprinting. Every single human being carries their own identity in their DNA. This unique identity is attributed to the 0.1% difference in the specific DNA pattern. Dr. Alec Jeffries in 1985 introduced a technique that gave genetic identity to an individual, known as DNA fingerprinting or DNA profiling. Let us learn about the principle and technique of DNA through the investigation of a crime scene. But, what are they looking for? There is evidence left behind by the perpetrator like hair follicle, saliva, semen, skin flakes or blood, where cells with nuclei can be isolated. Blood samples can serve as evidence and are collected in a test tube. Each drop of blood has small DNA pieces, and this blood dissolves in a test tube with blood sample A. The biological sample is sent to the forensic lab. Let's call it sample A. Here they have two more DNA samples, B and C, which have been collected from the suspects. These samples are then treated to isolate their DNA, which is the first step of the DNA fingerprinting technique. A closer look at the DNA of each sample shows that it possesses coding and non-coding sequences. Here, the non-coding DNA has short nucleotide sequences which are organized as tandem repeats. For example, the three highlighted parts are repeats of AGTCGGT in sample A. They are called VNTRs, also known as mini satellites. Similarly, we can see two highlighted regions of repeats in sample B and three highlighted regions of repeats in Now the gel is subjected to an electric current to perform gel electrophoresis. As the DNA is negatively charged, it will start moving towards the positive pole or anode. Let's closely observe the movement of DNA fragments inside the gel. The smaller fragments are quicker than the larger ones, so they travel farther than the larger ones in the gel. Thus, the DNA strands are separated depending on their length or number of base pairs. This is the principle on which gel electrophoresis works for the separation of differently sized DNA. Now soak the gel in an alkali. This leads to the denaturation of the double-stranded DNA to its single-stranded form. DNA is then blotted onto a nylon or synthetic nitrocellulose membrane. This technique is known as southern blotting. It reproduces the distribution of the DNA fragments on the gel. The membrane is then immersed in a solution containing radioactively labeled probes. Let us zoom into the membrane to closely observe the interaction of the sample DNA and the probe. These probes are the short nucleotide sequences complementary to the VNTR. The probe hybridizes with the isolated DNA fragments. The extra probe is then washed off, leaving behind only the radioactively labeled hybridized segments on the membrane. Now let us perform autoradiography. In order to do so, expose the membrane to the X-ray film. When the X-ray film is developed, a visual pattern of radioactively labeled DNA or DNA fingerprint can be observed on the autoradiogram. Since the enzymes cut the DNA into a unique combination of lengths, the bands formed will be distinct for different individuals. But here we find that the bands for sample A and sample C are the same. This shows that DNA samples A and C are from the same individual and the suspect is identified. Thus, DNA fingerprinting is a genetic technique of finding variable DNA sequences in order to determine the identity of an individual. Now that we know how incredibly useful DNA fingerprinting is in crime investigations, let us learn about its other applications. The process is used to solve legal disputes to determine paternity and also for personal identification. It's of great use in the diagnosis of and to find the cure to inherited disorders like Huntington's disease, thalassemia, sickle cell anemia, etc. Furthermore, DNA fingerprinting helps determine population and genetic diversities and facilitates the selective breeding of plants and animals like the Jersey cow. DNA fingerprinting is a genetic technique of finding variable DNA sequences to determine the identity of an individual. The steps involved in DNA fingerprinting are: the extraction of DNA from the cells with nucleus like hair follicle, blood, semen or skin flakes. Cut the DNA using specific restriction enzymes which results in fragments of DNA of variable lengths. Using gel electrophoresis, separate the DNA fragments according to their size. Soak the gel in alkali to denature the double-stranded DNA into its single-stranded form. Blot the DNA onto a nylon membrane. Immerse the membrane into radioactively labeled probes. This allows for the hybridization of sample DNA with a probe. Expose the membrane to an X-ray film. Observe dark bands of DNA fragments on the film.